Hey everybody, CJ here again for another prototype video blog. So today we're going to go over first shots. So what exactly is a first shot? What do they look like? I'm going to tell you all about them. So when you're making a toy, you have to make a mold out of a piece of steel, and then they basically inject that steel with the plastic, and the plastic hardens, and that makes the actual toy. But before they get to the final production run, they test these molds. And when they're testing them, sometimes things will be wrong. They'll have things they need to correct. The fit won't quite be right, or a joint will be too loose, something like that. So when they're testing them, they usually run just a few pieces. You know, maybe, I mean, when you turn on a machine like that, you're probably gonna run at least 50, because they run in like, one piece will take like 2 or 3 seconds to do it. So literally you turn on for like a minute and you're gonna get, you know, 30 or 40 pieces. So they turn it on and maybe run 50 or 100 of these. And when they're doing this, oftentimes they interrupt their regular production cycle. So they may be making, say, a Casey Jones figure on the line, and they need to test this mold, but they don't want to completely disrupt everything going on with Casey Jones. So they'll just take those tools off, put the new tools on. But the thing about it is that the plastic that's in the machines has some pipes and stuff to travel through till it gets to the mold. So if you really wanted to change the color, you have to do what's called a purge of the machine, which means basically running all the extra plastic through until all the old color runs through and the new color comes back out. It's kind of like when you turn on your water faucet from hot to cold and you have to wait till all the cold water gets out before the hot water gets in. Similar to that. So when they're doing first shots, they don't really care what color the shots are in. They're just looking to test to see if the mold works well, if the parts all fit together. The colors are irrelevant because these are never meant for sale. So usually what they'll do is they'll just throw the new tool up and run it in whatever color happens to be on the machines at that time. So like for my example of Casey Jones, you would throw the tool up, you'd run the parts in whatever Casey Jones colors were in there. You know, that might take you an hour to pick the tools down, put them up, run the shots, replace the tools, go back to the Casey Jones. And then you just restart that production line for Casey Jones and run them through. So you often, almost always see these first shots in really weird colors. So here's an example. Here's a first shot Muckman. You can see the crazy colors on him. Now, a lot of times first shots will lack production dates. This particular one has no production dates on it anywhere. Sometimes they will have production dates. The dates could be put on at any point in the process, and they're etched in after the main tool is made. So a lot of times the first shots are run before the dates are put on, but not always. If you see them in weird colors like this, that's pretty much a great clue that that's a first shot figure. So you can see, I haven't matched this up, but I'm guessing we could probably find some figures with maybe a tan torso and some blue arms that maybe this was interrupting the production run to run this particular first shot. So a lot of times the details won't be complete. I don't know about the production McMahon, but I know a lot of the turtles had the little ridge around the feet. Sometimes little details like that might be missing on a first shot. Now, in engineering terms, You might run several shots of a tool if something's wrong with the first time. Generally speaking, as an engineer, we would call these test 1, test 2, test 3, T1, T2, T3, etc. But in the collecting world, generally anything, we sort of lump anything that's not a production shot into this term first shot. Even though technically the first shot is literally the first time you put the mold up and you run it. And sometimes you'll get really horrible parts you can't even use off of that. So, you know, this might actually be a T2. Don't really know, doesn't really matter. It's still a cool pre-production piece used in part of the process. I'm gonna show you one more here, and this one is probably more like a pilot figure. Now a pilot is when they've debugged all the tools, everything is ready to go, but they need to test the entire assembly line. So not only are their tools running right, but this part falls down into a bin and that rolls down a conveyor belt, and then the employees on the line might pick it up and assemble it and then do the welding and all the other things, paint ops, so the whole assembly line is tested. When that test comes into place, that's called a pilot run. So those figures usually aren't sold either, but they usually are very, very close to production. This figure is probably, most likely, out of a pilot run. And the reason I know that, you may say, well, that looks pretty much like a regular figure, but if you watch here, this figure is not welded together, and I can pull the torso apart. So you can see the inside there of the figure. So this is probably a pilot figure that just, they didn't quite have the welding done. So let me talk about sonic welding a bit. Sonic welding is, they'll put this thing in a little cavity like this, and a piece comes down called the horn, and that horn vibrates this thing at a high frequency. If you're in the room, when you hear this, it's a really high-pitched whine buzz that's almost out of the range of your hearing. It just goes really high. And what it does is it injects sonic energy into the plastic. It shakes these, I mean, I'm really exaggerating it, right? But microscopically shakes these together, which creates friction at the joint, and then melts a little bit of the plastic at the joint, and then that plastic dries or cools, and it basically has welded together. So this is definitely not a production because it's never been welded. And you can tell that if you look at it with a microscope, that there's a little ridge here and a matching groove on this side, that when those weld together, you can definitely tell that they've been melted together at the seam. So again, in the collecting world, we might call this a first shot. You might call it a pilot. You might call it an engineering pilot, or an EP is another term for a piece like this. I would personally probably label this one an EP, not so much a first shot. So the first shots are pretty much one of the last things that happens. And the pilot is actually the last thing that happens before you go into a production run. And the first shots are right before that. So we talked a little bit last time about the proof cards and packaging. So that would be sort of the final stage before the packaging is finished. This is pretty much the final stage before, oh, there goes his arm.